Jude, we can't hear you.
Okay. Can you hear me now? Okay. Tonight's reading opening word is by Mary Oliver. It's called The Poet Thinks About the Donkey.
The second reading from the Gospel of Mark, chapter 11. When they were approaching Jerusalem at Bethphage and Bethany, near the Mount of Olives, Jesus sent two of his disciples and said to them, "Go into the village ahead of you, and immediately as you enter it, you will find there a colt that has never been ridden. Untie it and bring it. If anyone says to you, 'Why are you doing this?' just say this: 'The Lord needs it and will send it back here immediately.' They went away and found a colt tied near a door outside in the street. As they were untying it, some of the bystanders said to them, 'What are you doing untying the colt?' They told them what Jesus had said, and they allowed them to take it. Then they brought the colt to Jesus, threw their cloaks on it, and he sat on it. Many people spread their cloaks on the road, and others spread leafy branches that they had cut in the fields. Then those who went ahead and those who followed were shouting, 'Hosanna! Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is the coming kingdom of our ancestor David. Hosanna in the highest heaven.' Then he entered Jerusalem and went into the temple. And when he had looked around at everything, as it was already late, he went out to Bethany with the 12. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people. Thanks be to God.
Well, today is Palm Sunday. We recall Jesus' triumphal entry into Jerusalem through our second reading this evening from the Gospel according to Mark. And we hear about the donkey who carried Jesus into Jerusalem that day through Mary Oliver's wonderful poem, "The Poet Thinks About the Donkey." Today, the week of Jesus' passion and death begins as Jesus rides into Jerusalem on a colt to shouts of Hosanna and blessing that will soon turn into shouts of Crucify Him. It was a week of plotting and conspiring by the chief priests and scribes together with Judas. There was the Passover meal with the disciples, and then Jesus' agony in the garden. There was Jesus' betrayal and arrest, and then there was that sorry excuse for a trial. His disciples fled or denied him, and Jesus stood alone before Pilate, who sentenced him to death. What followed was Jesus' crucifixion and burial. And all this in a matter of days. All this in a matter of days once, and only once, and for all. Jesus will not, nor does he need to, go through it again. When I was a teenager, I took a ride on a motorcycle. My father told me never to get on a motorcycle, and so of course I did. I had to try it at least once. And I remember sitting behind the boy who was driving with my arms wrapped very tightly around his waist, and at the same time burying my head into his back. I was pleading with him not to drive too fast, and my father's admonition was swirling around in my head. Well, we took off, and I held on for dear life. My arms were wrapped around him so tight, I'm not too sure I really knew how he could breathe. And as I said, my head was buried into his back, and I was holding on as if my life depended on it. And if the danger didn't register, the fear certainly did. Why hadn't I listened to my father? When I got older, I listened a little bit better, but that's still iffy. Well, tonight we begin the ride into Jerusalem on the back of the donkey with our arms wrapped around Jesus and our heads buried in his back, holding on for dear life, because indeed, our very life does depend upon it. The glorious news for you and me is that when we enter Holy Week, we ride in with the one who has gone before, who knows the way, who has truly confronted and conquered the obstacles. And you and I know how it all turns out. You and I know that at the end of Holy Week comes Easter. You and I know that after death comes life, new life, resurrection life. You and I know that with every Calvary comes Easter. And so you and I have the incredible opportunity to relive and reclaim what it means to be buried with Christ in his death and to live in the power of his resurrection, to join Jesus in this week and all that comes after it. So my prayer as we begin Holy Week is that each of us will be encouraged to get on the back of that colt with Jesus and wrap our arms around him and bury our heads in his back, and hold on for dear life, and let Jesus take us for the ride of our lives. May God's name be praised. Thank you.
Thank you. loving God, in faithfulness we pray to you. That you will arouse us from sleep and make us alert to anticipate the nearness of your presence.
Spirit of God, may we follow closely your lead.
That this may be a season to discover your forgiveness freely given, your touch in every human embrace, and your love in every gesture of sacrifice between us.
Generous God, redeem our anxieties and fears, turn them into new hope and confidence.
That your grace may bring in our hearts to fresh awareness of the pain in the world, and make us see with uncovered eyes the Christ who suffers with his people in their troubles.
Seeing God, give us eyes to see beyond the obvious.
That we may hold close all those in any kind of trouble. Nicole, David and his family, Malcolm, John, Victor, Patrick and family, Tim, Amelia and Abigail, Karen and Charlie, Sarah, Bill, Elaine, Debbie, Abigail, Margaret, Jessica, Amelia, Deborah, Josh, Tracy, Priscilla, Robin and her family, Lana, Pete, Dan, David, Marjorie and Stacy, Mary Jill, Ted, Amelia, Dawn, Madison and their family, Rachel, and their others.
Molly.
May they be healing, wholeness, confidence, and peace. May we recognize in our own gatherings for prayer and thanksgiving that you are with us here to receive our songs of hope and gratitude. We give thanks for the birth of Benjamin Brumley, grandson of Hank Osier. We give thanks for our discernment committee and pray for them, and for the clergy who will present themselves for discernment with us as we seek our next rector.
For Malcolm.
And like with God, we may accept the gifts of your spirit.
Receive those who have died into the arms of your love, and comfort those who mourn them. We pray for the repose of the soul of Robert Osier, son of Hank Osier, our dear Lord.
Doc Rasher.
Jens.
That you, in your mercy, will mend our brokenness and restore our relationship with you and our neighbor.
For the gift of God, turn us to the path of righteousness, and guide our lives to sin and holiness.
That the works of our lives may demonstrate your law.
O God, confess on all people, will, and with capacity for forgiveness, and all longing for peace.
Receive our prayers, and in your grace, answer them as they be best for us and your people.
God of compassion, you have called us to know you and to make you known.
Grant that we may walk in your presence, your love in our hearts, your joy in our minds, your strength in our souls, until in the end of our journey. We have the joy of our womanhood and of Jesus.
I ask those of you on Zoom to unmute yourself. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Peace, everyone.
Peace, everyone. Peace. Good to see you, Malcolm.
Peace to Malcolm.
Peace, all.
Peace.
Peace, Suzanne.
Peace, Lisa.
Lisa.
Peace, Malcolm.
Peace, Gordon.
Peace, Gordon.
Peace, Gordon. Peace, Gordon. Love you.
Peace, Judy.
Yeah, peace.
Margaret. Peace, Donald. Oh, what a great picture, Donald. Margaret, peace.
Thank you.
Peace, Joan.
We're all looking that way because that's where the screen is. We can see you all. So just know that. Well, welcome, everyone. I want to draw your attention to the announcements. I won't be wordy tonight. Everything's there for this week. We have services every evening at 7. On Monday and Tuesday, we have the evening prayer of Compline on Zoom only. And then there will be a musical Taizé service. Maybe you're familiar with Taizé. It is a monastic community in France. And they have created a lot of music that's very easy to sing. And so that will, Joel and the choir are putting that together. And that will be on Zoom only on Wednesday evening at 7. And then our Monday, Thursday service will be here and on Zoom at 7. And our Good Friday service will be here and on Zoom at 7. And Joel is putting together some music that will go out in the invitation to worship, or we'll get to you somehow, of music for Good Friday that you can listen to at any time. But we're only doing the 1 hour because of the constraints to the pandemic. And then Easter in the morning, and also at 5:30, we will be here in the room and also on Zoom at 5:30. There you go. Lots of possibilities to pray our way through and ride with Jesus into Jerusalem and to the cross and beyond. I want to also put a shout out to those of you who are working on the Zergine and all of that. We could use some folks to help with the technology and also to do the setup.
And take down
our room. In the room here. So please see Aaron, our coordinator, if you can help in that regard. Okay. Did somebody else have an announcement?
Oh, one more announcement.
Yeah.
That we are going to be having our Celtic community gathering.
Yes.
And then we've been listening to everyone's concerns and input. And after Easter, we'll be planning that.
Great.
But the leadership committee has been listening and continuing to track.
Got it.
No.
Yes. So I don't know if you all picked up that, what Aaron was saying. We'll have an opportunity to gather as a larger group after Easter to talk about how things are going. And there are some concerns about Eventide that have been voiced. Through email, and there'll be an opportunity to share that with me and also with Aaron, and to talk about it with one another. I hope you'll consider that. But anyway, so dates and all that, a date will come out, but it'll be after Easter for many good reasons. So, be imitators of God as God's beloved, and walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us, an offering and a sacrifice to God.
Yep. We need to do that.
Brian, as you're able. The Lord be with you.
And with us, we are here.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up unto the Lord our God.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
To the Lord our God, we are thankful for praise.
Great Creator Spirit, from whom all life comes forth, here we are gathered again with bread and wine, seeking your presence and your peace, longing once more to be nourished. We hunger for wholeness in our lives, for unity on earth, and for peace among the nations. We know that only in your love can such peace and unity be found. So, with all that we are and all that we can give, we join with all of creation as we sing your praises. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is your creation, O Lord. All the earth reflects your glory. Blessed is the fruit of the earth, which sustains us in this earthly life. Blessed is your Son, Jesus, who came to heal and bring wholeness by the forgiveness of sins. In life and in death, he revealed your glory. In life and in death, he awakens in us the hope that all powers of evil are fall, and that your love will reign. On the night before he suffered, Jesus took bread, and lifting it up and giving thanks to you, he blessed it, broke it, and gave it to his friends, saying, "Take and eat this, for this is my body, which is given for you." Then he took the cup, blessed the wine, and gave it to them, saying, "Take and drink this, for this cup is my blood, which shall be shed for the forgiveness of all. Whenever you do these things, you shall remember me." And so, Lord, in memory of Jesus, we, your children, offer you these gifts. We call now on your Holy Spirit to bless them, the holy bread of life and the cup of eternal blessing, and to make them be for us the food of heaven. Accept with them the sacrifice of our hearts, that all who share in this bread and this cup may be blessed in your love, and that through this love we may be instruments of your peace. We pray this in the name of Jesus, your Son. Amen. As our Savior Christ has taught us, we now pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Broken bread, poured out wine, signs of Christ's self-giving.
Broken bread, poured out wine, food for the human soul.
Broken bread, poured out wine, sacrifice for the world's peace. The gifts of God for the people of God, take them in remembrance that Christ died for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. us pray.
We give you thanks, O God, for calling us together and for sustaining us with this holy meal. This place is sacred, this time is sacred, and in this sacredness we have shared a mystery. May we, in every place and time, recognize the sacredness of life, and may we accept the mystery as we accept your love, with joyful faith and eternal hope. In Christ's Almighty God, we pray you graciously to behold this your family, for whom our Lord Jesus Christ was willing to be betrayed, given into the hands of sinners, and to suffer death upon the cross, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Sorry.
That's the flute.
Yes.